But I know her better than any of you.
Oh, stop. I've spent just as much time with the girl as you have.
It's all here on paper. We really shouldn't discuss it.
I do not
believe
that Nurse
Johnson.
We absolutely
must discuss it.
It's a matter of utmost importance.
All right. That's quite enough. We've all said our piece.
Doctor, you're missing the point.
Nurse Johnson!
Clara's confinement here is unwarranted and unethical. We could ruin a perfectly sane young woman. Destroy her chances at ever having a normal life.
The girl's uncle can't be ignored.
The man is a complete fraud. Must I say it again? He only brought her to us because he
doesn't
didn't
want to care for a paraplegic.
We understand. We have heard you. You sound like a broken record.
Do we have any actual evidence that his accusations are true?
He described her suicide attempts in vivid detail.
So it's his word against hers? Am I the only one who realizes how absurd the situation is?
It has been and continues to be my diagnosis that Miss Salato suffers from acute melancholy, something you refuse to acknowledge.
Melancholy. Her mother and father are dead. The accident left her in a wheelchair for life. And then her uncle dropped her off here. Don't you think a little bit of melancholy is only natural?
Dr. Harlan, I do not believe that Nurse Johnson has the experience to try and decide whether or not
a
patient should be committed.
Mrs. Barringer and I have a train to catch. Has this been settled?
Unfortunately, the presentation today from our friends at the state leave me with no choice. Clara must remain in our care. We will revisit the case in 6 months.
Doctor, 6 more months here will make her just as sick as the others.
I'm sorry, Evelyn, but this really is the best option at this time.
Light upon the good, and darkness is consumed in evil.
And Dr. Harlan to Ward 3. Dr. Harlan to Ward 3.
I'm not crazy! You're crazy! Let me go! You want to
stop? Nancy, everything's gonna
go.
Be fine.
Let me, please.
Do you have to be so rough with her? Nurse Archer, is this necessary?
I decide what's necessary to maintain order in this ward, not you, Johnson. Thank heavens. Here comes Dr. Harlan.
No!
Come on.
No! Okay, my problem.
Nancy, I need you to relax for a moment.
Easy.
She'll be feeling better in no time. Thank you, Nurse Archer.
Of course, Doctor.
Johnson?
Perhaps they'll shock a little more sense into her this time.
It's barbaric.
No one's asking you. All right, excitement's over. Resting hour has begun. Return to your rooms immediately. Now! Oh, Johnson, I have to cover for Marge in Ward 6 for about an hour, which means you and Betsy will have to finish the rounds, which means that you will have to work faster. No long conversations. And don't even think about painting Bernice's nails again. Did I say something funny?
No, Nurse Archer.
Good. Because you are skating on thin ice.
Watch yourself. Hold still, Bernice. Okay, okay. All right. There.
Do you feel as beautiful as you look?
I'm so beautiful.
Good.
Oh. Oh. Got the papers! Got papers!
Okay. Damn headaches.
Got papers!
It's all right. It's all right. Oh. Oh. It's just a headache. It's just my headache.
Pain. Head. Pain.
I think it's time for me to take my aspirin.
Ooh. Oh, I like medicine. I like the kind they give me at night. Makes me forget, though. Does your medicine make you forget?
Oh, no, sweetheart, this is aspirin for my headache, that's all. Oh, where does the time go? Your neighbor Clara's waiting for me.
Clara was so sad. So sad.
Well, I intend to cheer her up.
That's so funny! That's so, so funny! That's so funny!
All right. I'll see you tomorrow. You girls behave. With your head again, dear.
Oh, God, Joan, you scared me.
Mental analysis of patient 754.
I'm sorry, but that's none of your business.
How dare you? Hospital business is my business.
Well, this doesn't concern you.
If you are trying to free another one of those animals,
they're
I am going to...
animals, Joan. They're patients. They're people.
Oh, how sweet. We have a budding hero in our midst. We're all getting quite tired of you, Evelyn.
Joan, please get out of my way.
If I had my way, I would have sent you packing months ago.
Stop it, please.
I think the doctor must pity you.
Why do you have to be such a bit?
Do not forget your place.
I need an aspirin now, too.
Oh, no, I think what you need is some rest. Come on.
Miss face red.
Oh, no, it's okay. It's all right. Come on. We'll go color. It's okay. Yeah. How are you feeling today, Clara?
I'm fine. Clara, I know it helps you to see their faces, but you have to keep this hidden.
Nurse Archer will be very cross if she knows I let you have it.
Do you think that woman ever tires of being ruthless?
No. You almost got me in trouble earlier, by the way. All right, deep breath. Good.
Next week can't come soon enough. I'm hoping that they believe you this time. Well, fortunately, your uncle's been quiet the past couple of months. I think we have a real chance. Come on, another one.
Excellent.
If they keep me in here any longer, I may actually go crazy.
Well, I'm almost finished with my report, and I have some very convincing arguments.
They keep saying I'm depressed.
I know, Clara. But you have to remember, the doctor has over 800 patients to monitor. He doesn't know you like I do.
I don't even exist to him. I'm just a number. Sometimes I feel like I don't matter.
You matter to me.
Okay. All right, what do we have here?
No. Oh. What's the matter?
That's just a stiff neck.
Oh my God, you have a monster of a bruise. What happened?
I must have slept on it funny.
All right, well, why don't I get you some ice and maybe some aspirin for the pain, okay? I'll be right back.
What are you up to?
I'm doing my job.
Evelyn, are you all right?
What, is everyone against me now?
Nobody's against you. We're just concerned.
It's no use. She won't listen to us. I've spoken to Dr. Harlan.
What?
He's expecting you. Let's go, Betsy.
Wonderful.
It's not in your chart.
Nothing happened. Please.
Nothing happened.
Please don't get upset.
Clara, I know electroshock bruises when I see them. When did they do it? Clara.
She told me not to tell you.
Who?
Please, I can't.
Nurse Archer?
They'll put me in an isolation room in the basement.
Clara, that's absurd. There are no isolation rooms in the basement.
Where do you think they put Nancy? After her shots.
I honestly don't even know what to believe anymore.
Damn this place! I'm sorry, Clara.
No. I can't take it anymore.
Clara.
There's only so much your brain can handle.
I know. This is a complete outrage. I'll march into the doctor's office. I'll demand an explanation.
No.
I'll see to it.
No, please
again.
Don't. That'll only make it worse.
Clara, I won't sit by while they hurt you like this.
No.
Clara, you have to keep it together. Come on, baby.
I need to get out of here.
The doctor doesn't listen to me this time.
I'll walk you out of here myself, I promise you.
Evelyn. I can't take this much longer.
Dr. Harlan?
Oh, come in. Close the door. Please, sit. I swear the paperwork never ends.
Why wasn't I informed about Clara?
What are you referring to?
You gave her electroshock treatment therapy, and you kept it from me. No, thank you.
We didn't tell you because you have no authority in matters such as these.
You knew I would try to stop you.
I knew it would upset you.
It was a choice I had to make. I find it interesting that you're bringing it up now.
When should I bring it up, Doctor?
Do you know why I asked to speak with you, Evelyn?
I can only imagine the things that Nurse Archer has been telling you, Doctor, but honestly, you know how committed I am to working with the patients.
You don't have to defend yourself, Evelyn. I know how much you care for them. But perhaps therein lies the problem. I'm concerned you might be spreading yourself too thin.
I'm quite fine, honestly.
You're tired, and it's affecting your work. I must insist that you take a sabbatical.
What? Doctor, the patients need me, and next week we have the review, so there's
no... The other nurses are perfectly capable in your absence. Everything else can wait until you return.
But what about Clara?
What about her?
Well, it's not right, and it's not fair.
Life can be that way sometimes. I know this is all very difficult for you. Evelyn, how are your headaches?
Fine. Aspirin helps.
Well, I hope with a good dose of rest and relaxation, they'll be gone. This is a bit stronger than aspirin.
No, thank you.
Please. You deserve some relief. Very good. Now I want you to go upstairs and collect your things. I've arranged for a car to take you to the train station in the morning. Your sister's expecting you.
You already phoned my sister.
Everything's been taken care of, Evelyn.
Will that be all, Doctor?
For now.
But why did you give her shocks? I don't understand.
That's enough, Evelyn. We've been through this.
You.
It's fine. I'm sure I'll be back soon.
Maybe it'd be good for you to leave this dreary place for a little bit. I'm envious.
Well, I'm gonna say goodbye to some of the patients. I'll be back.
But they're asleep. Nurse Archer will be furious with both of us if you cause a stir.
Nurse Archer doesn't have to know. Clara? Oh my God.
Where is she?
Shh! Archer's gonna hear you. What's going on?
Clara! She's not in her room!
What?
She's not there, Betsy! Where is she?
Okay, I'm gonna call the doctor.
No!
You need to let me call the doctor.
No. I have to find her. He might be behind this.
What are you saying?
Isolation.
What? I don't know what you're talking about.
The basement.
Nurse Archer, we have a situation.
Johnson.
Settle down.
Mom.
Please.
Where am I? You drugged me. Get off of me.
Hey.
I know what's happening. I have
work. Johnson, you're a nurse. Control your emotions.
It's all right. It's all right. Let's get some coffee. Come on. It's all right.
I'm so tired. No! 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 No!
It really was quite the experience falling down all those stairs. They tell me I'm lucky it was only a mild concussion. But really, I'm so glad it's over. The doctor has agreed to let me spend more time with the patients, especially with you. I spoke with Bernice for nearly an hour this morning. She's such a sweetheart. But you know, I think we're gonna have you out of here really soon. My report's nearly finished now, and I can't imagine...